Welcome to Friday's quiz. Does anyone remember what I told you the theme is going to be today? Hey, Benji. Anyone remember? So, you remember,
It's
Benji?
an International Woman's Day.
Ah,
It's International Woman's
Day.
Day.
Yeah, very good, Zane and Ruby. It is International Women's Day. So, all of our questions today are celebrating women. So, if you are a boy or a man here, you can celebrate your mums, your sisters,
Oh,
any
don't forget,
inspiring female people in your life. So, I
don't
know
forget.
we all have some. So, I'm
Don't
gonna start sharing my screen. I'm
forget.
gonna put you guys on mute. So, remember, write your answers down. We'll do five, go through the answers, and then go through the second five. Please do try and get yourself on mute until we go through them, because a lot of you have good answers and we don't want to help other people, do we now? And Wendy is going to be helping me today, Wendy N. And so, Wendy, if people are coming off mute or visit people late, if you just, yeah, mute them and or let them in for me. Right, let's get sharing. I'm going to mute you all and share screen. Okay, so there's a bit of a mixture today of a few history questions, a few sport questions, a couple of entertainment, and then some music to finish. So hopefully there'll be something for everyone. Let me just make this a bit bigger. Right, can everyone see my screen okay? Thumbs up. Perfect. So welcome to International Women's Day quiz, 12th of March. Sounds very formal, doesn't it? Okay, so our first question. So we're starting off with a few history ones. There we go, stay. Who was the first female Prime Minister in the United Kingdom? Was it Margaret Trolley, Margaret Thatcher, Margaret Truman, or Margaret Troops? Okay, and I've given you a picture, which might help a little bit as well. So, you guys wouldn't have been alive. I don't think anyone would have been alive when she was in power. But very famous woman. So, who was the first female Prime Minister in the United Kingdom? Was it A, Margaret Trolley, B, Margaret Thatcher, C, Margaret Truman, or D, Margaret Troops? So if you're unsure, as always, have a go, have a guess, because you do have 1 in 4 chance of getting it right. And as usual, I don't mind if you ask a parent or a sibling as well, because I think probably parents will know this because they would have been alive, unless they're very young, but I'm pretty sure yeah, they'll know this. Okay, moving on to number two. What was Florence Nightingale's profession? So she's someone that I think some of you would have done about in history at school. Was she A, a shopkeeper, B, a singer, C, an athlete, or D, a nurse? Who knows what Florence Nightingale did? You're right, Toby. Pretty much show us. So what was Florence Nightingale's profession? Was she A, a shopkeeper, B, a singer, C, an athlete, or D, a nurse? I think Elion knows. So these first few probably are slightly more difficult, but I wanted to challenge you and us to learn a little bit of history as well. Welcome, Amelia. Amelia, I'm going to read out number two one more time quickly for you, and then you can do number one when we go through them. And then if I'm rushed on number two, you can do it again when we go through, but I'll just quickly read it one last time. So, what was Florence Nightingale's profession? Was she A, a shopkeeper, B, a singer, C, an athlete, or D, a nurse? And if I'm going to give you one clue, it is relevant to what's been going on this year. She would have been amazing. Okay, question number three. Books such as The Tales of Peter Rabbit were written by who? Was it A, J.K. Rowling, B, Anne Fine, C, Beatrix Potter, or D, Sylvia Plath. So the Tales of Peter Rabbit are pretty famous. I think most of us, I'm not saying everyone, so I never know, but I feel like a lot of you might have seen books, films, cartoons, and they're written by a very famous lady, J.K. Rowling, Anne Fine, Beatrix Potter, or Sylvia Plath. Put your hand up if you think you know, so I can get an idea. Well done, Will. Well done, Ellie. Thought you'd know this, Ellie. Ellie, do you like the book? Yeah. Oh, cool. Yeah, I thought you would. Okay, let's move on to number four. If you do need me to slow down at any point, just raise your hand in the air. And Wendy, if you keep looking as well, so we can see both pages together. Right. Number four. So moving on to sport now. Who is GB's current number one female sprinter? So she's recently been on our screens at the Indoor Athletics Championships. Is it A, Sally Gunnell, B, Dina Asher-Smith, C, Amy Pratt, or D, Jessica Ennis? And hopefully this year in the Olympics, she might get a medal for us, which would be amazing.
Dina Asher-Smith.
Keep off mute, guys, if you can.
Oh.
We don't want to give people a clue. I'm not sure who that was. Oh, Alex is here. Stuff. So, number four. Wendy, is it right just to let those people in? Oh, so that's cool. Yeah, Jess has got in as well. Hi, Alex. Alex, we're on number four. So, you'll have to just catch up when we go through the first five. Okay, so number four. Who is GB's current number one female sprinter? Is it A, Sally Gunnell, B, Dina Asher-Smith, C, Amy Pratt, or D, Jessica Ennis? And remember the picture as well. Hopefully can give you a clue. You might recognise that lady. Ah, good, everyone saying hi in the chat. Hey, everyone. Yeah, feel free to chat in the chat, as long as it's not directly about the answers. Okay, hi, Jess, how are you? Okay, so number five, last one before we go through the first five answers. Which women's team won gold in Rio 2016? So the last Olympics. Okay, was it the women's hockey team, the women's football team, the women's cricket team, or the women's rugby team? And again, the picture hopefully gives you some kind of clue if you don't know the answer. If you look behind, what the pitch might look like, maybe what they're wearing, might give you a clue. Yeah, well done, Benji. So, which women's team won gold in Rio 2016? Was it A, hockey, B, football, C, cricket, or D, rugby? Alex? Alex, you should get this one. I wondered as well, did anyone watch this match or remember seeing it? Because the news was delayed for it and it was a pretty epic match. Bet I know Debbie did. Did you see it, Steve, as well? No? Yeah, not sure. Okay. Right. How about you, Coco? Did you see the Olympics?
I saw it, Emma.
You saw it?
Yeah.
Ah, amazing. So do you know the answer then? Yeah. Brilliant. Okay, so one more time. Which women's team won gold in Rio 2016? Was it A, the hockey team, B, the football team, C, the cricket team, or D, the rugby team? Okay, we are going to go through the first five answers. I'm going to pick people, and then for the first five, then for the second five, what we can nominate ourselves. Okay, so I'm going to ask the first one, and then I'm going to get Wendy to pick someone for the second. So Wendy, if you want to come off mute, and then you can, be ready to help. Okay, so who was the first female prime minister in the United Kingdom? Was it A, Margaret Trolley, B, Margaret Thatcher? Wait, guys, C, Margaret Truman, or D, Margaret Troops? So,
Margaret Truman.
Late. So, if you just want to put quickly.
Margaret Bowder.
Margaret Truman.
Margaret Bowder.
B. Okay, I am going to ask Ilium, because I can tell he wants to answer this one.
Margaret Bowder.
Which one?
The B.
Thatcher.
Margaret Thatcher? Do we think it's B, Margaret Thatcher?
Yes.
You do?
Do you think it's B, Margaret Thatcher?
Yes, Chris. Very good. It is. It's B, Margaret Thatcher. Good work, guys. And yeah, hopefully you guys, a few that joined late, got a chance to write that down. Well done. Okay. Number two, going to read it, and then Wendy's going to decide who she wants to answer. So, what was Florence Nightingale's profession? Was she A, a shopkeeper, B, a singer, C, an athlete, or D, a nurse? Please don't shout out. I'm going to get Wendy. Can you pick who you think you'd like to answer this one for me?
Ruby.
Ruby?
Nurse.
Think she was a nurse?
Yeah.
Nurse, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to ask one more person as well to see if we're in agreement. Coco, which one do you think it is?
D. The nurse.
Okay, so Wendy, do you also think it's nurse? Wendy G. You say you had your hand up.
It's D.
I think it's D. Okay. Mm-hmm. I am happy to tell you all that that is the correct answer, D, nurse. Okay, the next one I am going to ask Kay to answer. Books such as The Tales of Peter Rabbit were written by who?
J.K.
Rowling, C, Beatrice Potter, or D, Sylvia Plath?
Beatrice Potter.
Okay, so I don't think your name's a K, unless K's voice has changed. Let's ask K, and then we can get a second opinion.
The Beats.
Okay, wait, guys. Let's just ask K, and then I'll ask you. Okay, I like the excitement. We just want to get everyone having a go. Where's
A.
You think it's A, K?
Yeah.
J.K. Rowling.
C.
Okay, so Toby. So thanks for that, Kay. You think it's A, an amazing author, J.K. Rowling. But what do you think it is, Toby?
No, the Beats.
Annie Fine.
The Rabbit.
Yeah.
Did you say C, Toby?
I did.
Okay, so C, Beatrix Potter, is the right answer. So anyone that got anything different, I'm afraid it's not right. J.K. Rowling wrote the Harry Potter books.
Oh.
So I can see where you put her down because we see her name all the time. But yeah, it's Beatrix Potter. Okay, number four. I'm going to ask Zane this one. Oh, sorry, no, Wendy, it's your turn to choose. Who would you like to choose, Wendy?
Amelia,
awesome. I'll choose you next, Zane. Otherwise, that's a bit mean, isn't it? Okay.
Who's
current number one female sprinter? A. Sally Gunnell, B. Dina Asher Smith, C. Amy Pratt, or D. Jessica Ennist. So GB's number one female sprinter.
Ennist.
You think it's Jessica Ennist?
Yeah.
Okay, it's a really good answer, but she's not a sprinter.
Wow.
So therefore, it's a different answer. Will, would you like to answer? If you just take yourself off mute, Will, or you can write in the chat if that's tricky.
Okay, I'm off mute. I think I've got it. One, I've put Jessica Ennis.
Okay, so that was the same one as Amelia, which I'm afraid is not correct. As I say, a really, yeah, really good try, really good guess, but she's not a sprinter, Jessica Ennis. She's a heptathlonist. I think that's how you say it. Okay, I'm going to ask Zane. Zane, have you got the answer for us?
God,
yes.
Where's Zane gone?
Dina Asher-Smith.
B, Dina Asher-Smith.
Ooh. Dina Asher-Smith.
Okay, Zane. Very well done. That is correct.
Yes.
It's Dina Asher-Smith.
Yes.
And if you don't know who she is, remember the name, because as I said, hopefully she'll be winning a medal in Tokyo for GB.
On this one.
Which will be very exciting. Okay, number five. I'm actually going to ask, because Zane's just answered, I'm going to ask Benji, number five. He looked like he knew this
hockey
one as well. And Wendy, okay, I'll ask you
hockey
next.
Hockey.
What do you say, Benji?
Hockey.
Oh. Do you agree, yes. Wendy N? Sorry, Wendy G. You can go off mute, Wendy.
Football. B.
You think it's B, football?
I do.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've got hockey and football so far. I'm going to ask one more person to see if we can get
football.
Unanimous vote. Alexandra, which one do you think it is?
Football.
Football.
You think it's football?
Yes.
Have a think about that one more time, Alex. What sport do you really love at the moment?
Nothing.
I like swimming.
Okay, what are the options on the screen?
We're going to be football.
Okay, don't worry, Alex. I'm going to go to Ruby. She's ditching.
Hockey?
It's not.
You have to tell Debbie that as well.
Hockey.
Yeah.
It's not.
Hockey.
Yeah, so guys, the answer is A, hockey.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Yes.
But Alex, remember it's hockey. We won gold in Rio. Okay, really good, guys. We're going to move into the second half of the quiz.
It's not hockey. I'm going to
pull back on mute.
Two, three.
Good job.
Four, okay.
One.
Okay, we're back on mute. So let's rip through the next half. Number six. Who co-hosts Strictly Come Dancing? And I'm not giving you a clues this time. You get half a mark for the name of each lady. So I know a lot of you do watch the programme, but do we know the names of the two female presenters? So number six, who co-hosts Strictly Come Dancing? And they're on your screen. Ilion, do you watch it? Put your thumbs up if you watch Strictly Come Dancing, Ilion.
No.
You don't watch it?
No.
Ah, okay. It might be hard then, this one.
I do, Emma.
You watch it.
Do you like Strictly Come Dancing?
You watch it, Chris.
I do watch it sometimes.
Sometimes. Okay, again, if you need a bit of help from someone at home, that's fine. But try and make a few questions not so easy. Okay, number seven. Name the group. So I don't think we played their music on Thursday and dance, but we've definitely played them recently. Toby knows. I know, Ruby, I think you've got the group. You definitely request them a few times. It's all right, Toby. So which musical group are this? And I'm not going to give you any clues. But as I said, we've played their music quite a few times recently. We're all pretty good with music as well. Okay, number eight. So the last three, we're going to move on to some tunes. So I've got a clue for you who sings the song. But for number eight, you need to name for me. So let's turn the speaker on. Okay, so you need to name the song that you're about to hear, and it's by this artist on your screen. So I've been a little bit kind. Okay, sorry, it's been a little bit slow. Bear with me. And it's actually silenced as well. Okay. I was searching in the wrong place. Sorry, guys. This is a disaster. Cancel. Right. This. It's coming right up. I almost feel I should have asked someone to speak. Okay, it's coming. Name the song. Do you want to dance? You can. That's what people say. That's what people say. Yes, Toby. Yes, Amelia and Owen. Okay. So that's enough of a song for you. Hopefully, by the reaction, a lot of people know the name of the song and the singer is on the screen. Okay. Number 9.
I don't see the image.
Okay. So this is a real girl power song. But which group sung it? Yeah, I thought you like it, Amelia. I'll play 5 more seconds. Okay. Oh yeah, I was trying to get it to this bit, which, okay. Okay, listen to this bit. Yes, Owen. Okay, yeah, I was trying to get to that bit because that gives more of a clue. Okay, so this is one of the most, I think the most famous girl group of all time. So they were big just before a lot of you guys, were kind of in your music stage, but pretty sure quite a few will know who they are. Okay, last one. I want you to name the singer of this song. God, so I'm having issues with my Spotify this afternoon. Okay. So again, this woman is an incredible lady. So this, what is her name? And please dance if you wish.
Crazy in Love.
Okay, the songs have definitely got you up on your feet, which is just what we wanted. I feel like maybe I'll play one at the end and we can dance to finish. What we'll do, we can pick out the 3 songs, which one we want to play to finish. Okay, so we need to go through the last five now. And I'm aware we've got about 5 minutes left. So we're going to go back to number six, the last five. And I'm going to ask Chris if he knows who these two ladies are. So who co-hosts Strictly Come Dancing?
Yeah.
Wait, Leon, let's let Chris answer first, okay?
I don't know how the co-hosts are, they?
Okay, so I'm not sure who they are.
Yeah.
Okay, no problem. Give me a wave if you think you know, and then I'll come to you, Ilion. But I just want to see if someone else wants to answer first. Will, would you like to tell us?
Daily.
Who do you think they are, Will?
I think, is it Tess and Claudia? Because I can see the image. That's the answer.
Okay, that's very impressive. So it is Tess and Claudia. I'll give you the full mark for that. But would anyone like to add and tell us the surnames as well?
I'm not doing that, no.
Shishi, you're not sure, Chris.
It is the answer, isn't it?
Does anyone know the surnames? Go on, Ilion. Who are the... So say that one more time, Ilion. Okay, good. So Tess Bailey, and then Claudia. It's Claudia Winkleman. That's a little bit hard to say. So Tess Daly and Claudia Winkleman. But if you just got the first names, that's absolutely fine. You can have the mark. Because I don't think you would have confused it with any other Tesses.
No.
Okay, awesome. Thanks, guys. Right, number seven. I am going to ask Owen this question. Okay, because he hasn't answered one yet. Where's Owen gone on my screen? Owen, do you know who this group is?
The Titterbits.
Wait, Toby, let's see if Owen...
Do you want me to answer?
Owen, are you able to come off mute? Or if you're not, just put your thumbs down and that's okay.
Who, me?
Oh, no, sorry. Owen Coughlin.
Yeah.
Sorry. I know your surname is Owens as well, isn't it?
Yeah, just call me Steve.
Yeah, that's why I call you Steve. Yeah, sorry.
I know.
Owen, which group do you think it is?
They're Little Gaga. Are they?
Little...
What do you think it is?
Little Mix.
Yes, I think you said it right there. Little Mix. Toby, yes. You think it's Little Mix too?
How about that?
Yay. Okay, fabulous. Thought you did. It is Little Mix. Okay. Right, I'm going to just do a very quick 5 seconds of the song. And then Wendy, can you pick who you want to answer this question? But let me just go back.
Who is having a go yet?
Shake it off.
You know this woman.
Shake it off?
By Taylor Smith.
Yes.
Okay, guys, I didn't hear what you just said, so I'm just going to play 5 seconds of it.
Can you hear me, please?
Come on.
Okay. Wendy, who would you like to answer this question?
Who haven't answered yet?
Yeah. Well, Smith.
I know.
Got done now, Emma.
You not go. Answer it.
Steve actually hasn't answered, I don't think. Ellie did answer one. Jess hasn't answered one yet, actually.
Yeah, Jess.
Got done now,
Emma. No worries, Amelia. I'll see you soon.
Bye.
Emma.
Wait a second, Leon. Do you want to come off meet Jess and tell us what song this was?
You know Taylor Swift?
Just wait.
Just wait.
Are you able to come meet Jess? Or you can put it in the chat if you like.
Yeah.
Chat. Very good, Jess. You're right. Shake It Off.
Shake It Off.
Correct.
By Taylor Swift,
Zayn, and others. Yeah. You are correct. Okay, we're going to ask Steve Owen this question because you haven't answered one yet.
Okay.
And see if you know this.
I think I know.
Yes.
Right, Steve, did you get this one?
Yes, Stop from the Spice Girls.
Yeah.
Yes.
Spice Girls.
It is. Spice Girls are amazing. I used to dress up as a Spice Girls when I was a kid, which is a great
thought. I was a
child too.
You did too, Chris.
I think a Spice Girls is correct answer.
Yeah. So anyone that's got the Spice Girls, that is correct.
Yeah, me too. I think so.
Yeah,
I think
you're
so.
Right as well. Okay, last one. And we're just about in time. Okay, so 5 seconds of this one.
I know the song.
This is number 10.
Okay, so I'm going to ask Coco.
Yeah.
Wait, Ilion, I'm going to ask Coco first. Coco, which singer do you think this is? If you go off mute, Coco, I'm afraid I can't hear you.
No, it's just Cleo B, don't say.
Who is it?
Go on, Coco.
Beyonce!
Did you get Coco?
Yeah. Beyonce!
Yeah, very good. Wendy, did you get Beyonce as well? Wendy G. Yeah, good work, fellow. Okay, I'm going to stop sharing my screen so I can see you all. Hope you enjoyed that quiz today. Enjoyed the dancing. What we're going to do, we're just going to find out what your scores are. I've got a couple of quick announcements and then we will end with one of the three songs for about a minute and we can just have a little boogie before we go.
Yeah.
9 out of 10.
Yeah.
9 out of 10
as well.
Ooh, Ellie got 10. Well done, Ellie.
10.
8.
You want to say which song? So then it was Crazy in Love by Beyonce.
Yeah.
But you only needed to get Beyonce.
I'm firing.
I thought some of the history questions were hard. You got 10, Ilion.
I got 10.
Wow, we got lots of questions today. How did you get on, Owen and Wendy as well?
Ten.
What do you get, Wendy?
Ten.
8.
9.
Ten. It's the 10.
Okay, I'm going to quickly put you on mute and then I'll take a couple of questions because there's a lot of excitement going on. Okay, so just quickly before we play our song to finish with, you got 10, Alex, as well. Well done. That was really good fun today. Hope you enjoyed it, which I'm pretty sure you did. Next week is Comic Relief Day, or Red Nose Day, as it's commonly known. So, yeah, thanks, Demi. What is that? It was a cricket ball.
Don't forget.
Yeah.
It's not just, hey.
So, please, next week, can you wear something red if you've got it? And if you do have a red nose as well, I know some people might be buying them, wear that, but just something red is absolutely fine. And the theme is going to be on Red Nose Day and comedy. So we're going to be rolling on the floor laughing next week. So yeah, that should be fun. So yeah, tomorrow morning with Coach Debbie, we are doing athletics and it's going to be jumping and throwing. Debbie, is there anything they need to bring?
Yeah, if you could bring a piece of paper and a ball or a pair of socks. A small ball, please. A soft ball as well, if possible.
Is that a proper cricket ball you're holding? Soft one. Okay, good. Yeah, I was going to say. Don't get that ball near Ruby. It's too hard. Okay, thanks, Debbie. And then reminder, yeah, next week is as normal. And if you were, if you missed the session yesterday or haven't seen my email, we have a break over Easter online from, well, the last session is Thursday, the 1st of April, and then it's Good Friday. And then we're away for the following week and then back on the 12th of April, where we have some added extra special sessions because it is 1 year on from when our programme was launched. So we'll be receiving all details about that next week. But yeah, just dates for your diary so you can plan ahead. Okay, does anyone have any questions before we just dance to finish?
No.
No, okay, we're Wendy.
What are we doing for our 1 year anniversary?
What do you say, Zane?
What are we doing for one, what are we doing on Easter holiday sessions?
So I'll send you the whole schedule next week, but just for an idea, we're going to be doing, we're going to do some baking session, boxing, a one-off award ceremony and triathlon. So there's going to be a whole host of stuff. What do you say? Someone said about money. Ruby, did you have a question?
What's happening on Saturday?
Tomorrow?
And then Saturday, the, during the half term?
Oh, in the holidays? So the first Saturday, we'll have no session. And the second one, it's going to be a fun triathlon challenge with Debbie and myself.
Yep.
So, yeah, that will be that session. But tomorrow is an important one, which is some jumping.
What's
you can ask Debbie.
Code?
What was that, Alex?
What's the meeting code in East Holiday?
That's a good question. I have created it, but I'll send that
the
out.
Meeting
next...
code.
Yeah, I know. You'll remember off by heart as well, Alex, won't you? I'll send it next week. Yeah. When you can register for the event, you'll receive it. And I'll send it to you, but yeah, it's created but not gone out yet. So don't worry, I'll make sure you have it.
Yeah.
Okay, just for time's sake, can you put your hand in the air if you're happy that we just play 1 minute of Shake It Out? So I think that was probably the most popular overall. Okay, amazing. I'll play that for a minute. So if you want to come off mute, you can just have a little boogie and then I'm gonna end the call afterwards and I will see you all next week. And yeah, good to see you all. As of course. Okay, let's put that on. And if you want to sing, please go for it. Okay, show me some moves. Yeah. And thanks, Wendy, for your help.
Yeah.
Come persistent.
Oh, you can do this one. Oh, you can do this one of it. Good. How nice to see you two. Okay. Now you do this one. Have a good weekend. Listen to this. Come on. Listen.
Okay, if you love that song, put it on in your living rooms when we go off.
I love that song.
You love it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me too. Love it.
It's a great dancing song. Right, I will see you all next week. Have a good weekend and yeah, well done today.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.